So you want to animate the apex of human beauty in motion. Not a problem. Now, the female human walking cycle, in my opinion, is the most difficult animation you could possibly try to recreate by hand. This peak of human evolution is the perfect balance between science and art. And while I don't think it's really possible to capture the beautiful natural movements by hand, I do have a few tips to help you get close. Now, you can always tell how good an animator is by looking at their walk animation, so don't feel bad if you're having trouble. A good walk animation is like a final exam for most animators. I've been doing this for 9 years and I'm still not too satisfied with mine. One day, the patrons and I will save up enough money to buy a $7,000 state-of-the-art motion capture suit. And on that day, I will happily pay the most beautiful girl I can find to strut down in a room and record her perfection into an animation that you can apply to your own character rig. But that is not today. So, in the meanwhile, here are a few tips to keep in mind when attempting the hardest animation you could possibly do. When a confident, beautiful work of art walks towards your direction, you may have noticed there's a lot going on. And even if you don't exactly understand what, you can tell that there's a rhythm to it. And after doing this for years, I have noticed that 90% of this animation really just depends on 4 frames. So let's start with the first. Put the lead foot in the front and the back foot should rotate on the toe. Rotate the hips a tiny bit so that if the left leg is leading in the front, then the left hip should also be further up front. Also, note that the legs and arms naturally counterbalance each other. So if the left leg is in the front, that means the left arm should be in the back. And the same way that the hips move with the legs, the shoulders and torso need to move with the arms. So if the left arm is in the back, the left shoulder should also be rotated farther to the back. And if this is the case, rotate the left shoulder a tiny, tiny bit down. But not too much, women usually keep their chest pretty level to the ground. Once you've got the first frame, you literally are halfway done. Press A, I to key everything, copy the frame, go to the middle and paste it reversed. Okay, check it out. Now scroll to the middle, press A and I to make a new keyframe. Now this is the point where the arms should be overlapping each other. The leg that was in front should be dragging behind. And the leg that was in the back should be hovering in front with the ankles bent. Okay, now here is the most important part. This is the frame where you want to add hip sway. Not here. If the left foot was in front, the hips should not sway left until after she starts to bring her right foot forward. Contrary to what you might have thought, the hip direction is actually off beat with the dominant foot. So remember that. The dominant foot happens on these frames, the hip sway happens on these. Okay, once you got that, you're basically done. But for the cherry on top, go a couple frames right before the end and make sure that the lead foot is aiming up right before contact. I also think it looks better if you have the hands linger in the same area for these two frames, but that's up to you. Alright, once you have all this, the last thing is to press A, copy these two frames, and paste them over here, flipped and reversed. You're done. Hope that helps. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that bell. Hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you around.